In this demonstration, we'll show how to add a culvert to an SRH2D model in SMS. Let's move to the area where we will add a culvert. There is a relief culvert here near the bridge opening. As with the bridge, the element needs to be aligned with the culvert. Quadrilateral elements should also be used. As you can see, this has been done for this mesh. Next, we need to create arcs to define the culvert. Remember, the arcs must be added in the BC coverage. We could duplicate the coverage as we did for the bridge, but in this case, let's just add the arcs to the BC structure's coverage. This will simply add the culvert to the existing simulation with the pressure flow bridge. We'll now create the arcs defining the upstream and downstream edges of the culvert. As with the bridge, it is helpful to have the elements and elevation contours displayed. These arcs need to be located near the element edges that have approximately the same elevation as the culvert invert. The green in this picture is close to the invert elevation. We also need to remember to create these arcs in the same direction. The length of these arcs should be close to the distance between the end of the wing walls. These arcs define the elements where the flow will leave and re-enter the 2D domain. Let's also note the arc ID for this upstream arc. Now let's select both arcs, right-click, and select Assign BC. For the BC type, we select Culvert HY8, and then confirm that the upstream and downstream arcs are specified properly. Let's check Use Total Head. We now need to specify an HY8 crossing. If we select the drop-down menu, we see that there are no crossings defined. To define a crossing, we select the Launch HY8 button. We first need to select Culvert, New Culvert Crossing. This creates a new crossing and opens the Crossing Data dialog. This is the standard HY8 dialog for defining culvert parameters. Note that the discharge data and tailwater data sections are dimmed. We do not enter data in these sections since they are computed by SRH2D. We will complete the roadway data, culvert data, and site data sections defining our culvert. Here we'll specify our culvert size, type, number of barrels, length, invert elevations, and other parameters needed to define the HY8 crossing. We'll skip ahead to the completed dialog where we have filled in all of the parameters. The culvert crossing is now defined. Now that we have created a crossing, it appears in the list so we can select it. We have now defined our HY8 culvert. Since we included the culvert in the same BC coverage as the pressure flow bridge, we can now simply rerun the proposed structure's simulation. Keep in mind, this will overwrite the run with just the bridge. This concludes the demonstration for adding an HY8 culvert to an SRH2D model. In the exercise to follow, you will add a culvert to your model and run it again.